Today's video is a tale of drugs, revenge, and human Happy Meals.
We're taking a look at Maryland's cannibal cook, Joe Metheny. And quick note, guys, this series that we've been doing on the channel as often as we're trying to may get demonetized on YouTube, so please go and support us over on Patreon as we make our way with this. Also, another side note, sorry for my recent disappearance, I've been dealing with stuff, but I am back to the best of my abilities, just trying to get some stuff done.
According to Metheny's attorneys, he had been neglected as a child. His alcoholic father died in a car accident when Metheny was six. His mother neglected her six children while she worked her double shifts.
His mother, who Metheny claimed was dead, said that they were somewhat poor and she had to work hard as a waitress, barmaid, and food truck driver. But she provided her children with a normal family life and they were never gone hungry.
She went on to say Metheny was an above average student, always polite and never mean. To quote his mother, he was smart and had a good childhood. If he was neglected, it was his own fault. It was a pretty good home.
In 1973, when he turned 18, Metheny joined the United States Army. His mother said he served in Germany, although he said he served in a tour in Vietnam, where he became addicted to heroin while in the artillery unit.
His mother had no recollection of him serving in Vietnam, and the circumstances of his service were reported as unverified in the press reports. It's also worth pointing out that American involvement in Vietnam had ended by that time.
Metheny rarely contacted his mother after joining the army, and she said, "He just kept drifting further and further away. I think the worst thing that ever happened to him was drugs. It's a sad, sad story."
In the 1990s, at over 450 pounds, standing at 6'1", Metheny was ironically known as Tiny, and spent time in bars, living on the streets in South Baltimore, and spending nearly all of his money on drugs, from crack cocaine to heroin. However, he was still able to hold down a job, as he worked for a forklift driver at a pallet company, and was universally described as intelligent, well-spoken, and very well-mannered.
In 1994, Metheny murdered Kathy Ann Magaziner, a 39-year-old prostitute. He buried her in a shallow grave on site factory that he worked at, and it remained there for more than 2 years. Afterwards, he said he strangled her, dug up her skeleton 6 months later, put her head in a box, and threw it in the trash.
Sometime around here is when Metheny set out on his revenge mission. He wanted his son, but due to his record, he'd been unable to get him. And for losing custody of him, Joe wanted to murder his ex-old lady and her new man.
In 1995, he was arrested for allegedly killing two homeless junkies, Randall Brew and Randy Picker, with an axe.
In search for his wife and her man, he went to a homeless camp under Baltimore's Hanover Street Bridge. And when he couldn't find the people he initially wanted, he beat and interrogated two homeless men, then chopped them up with the axe. Then, due to being in the wrong place at the wrong time, a nearby fisherman was murdered and dumped in the river.
And then, in a wild turn of events, after dishing the murder weapon, a homeless man by the name of Larry Amor landed and used it to kill another homeless man, Evett Downwell.
The two axed bodies were discovered on August 2nd, 1995, the same day Downwell was killed. Amos was attested and accused of first-degree murder, and pleaded guilty to the lesser charge of manslaughter. He was released after serving a year and 9 months out of an 8-year sentence.
A jury concluded in July of 1996 that there was insufficient evidence to convict Metheny of murdering Bura and Piker, but he later said that he was in fact guilty of them.
In the same year, 1996, Joe killed some prostitutes, one of which being Kimberly Lynn Spicer, who he had stabbed to death. But this time, he wasn't disposing of the bodies in a river. Metheny instead opted for Sloppy Joe's.
He brought the bodies home on his trailer on the pallet company ground. He would then dismember them and store the meat in the freezer. Afterwards, he buried the unusable parts in a lot owned by the pallet company.
Back at home, he mixed some of the flesh with a mixture of beef and pork, forming it into patties. Over the next several weekends, he would sell these burgers out of a small barbecue stand that he opened on the side of the road.
For a few weeks, unwitting passerbys, truckers, and townies would consume the burgers, unknowingly consuming human meat.
According to Metheny, nobody complained about the meat. He'd killed 10 people, and quote, "The human body tastes very similar to pork. If you mix it together, no one can tell the difference."
Everything seemed to be going well for Metheny until December 8, 1996, when he made the mistake of kidnapping Reader Kemper.
Metheny shared drugs with Kemper, and when she refused to have sex with him, he attacked. causing her to flee. Joe was arrested on December 15th.
The owner of the pallet company was also arrested upon leaving a Christmas party and charged with being an accessory due to his disposing of evidence.
Matheny would later lead police to the burial site of Magaziner. I'm most definitely pronouncing that wrong. He confessed to killing three other prostitutes along Washington Boulevard in Baltimore, and said that he had thrown bodies into the Patapsco River. However, none were ever recovered.
He also appeared to show no remorse for anything he'd done, apart from one thing. To quote Matheny, "The one thing I feel bad about is anything of this is I didn't get to murder the two motherfuckers I was really after, and that's my ex-old lady and the best she hooked up with."
And he's also recorded as saying, though this feels like something you'd hear said to the audience during the end credits of a movie, "The next time you're riding down the road and you happen to see an open-pit beef stand that you've never seen before, make sure you think about this story before you take a bite out of that sandwich." That's apparently something that he said, but I got called a little bit of bullshit.
Initially, when he was found guilty, he was sentenced to death, which was overturned in 2000 and charged to two life sentences in 2017.
And on August 5th, 2017, the Burger King was found dead in his prison cell at the Western Correctional Institution in Cumberland, Maryland, at the age of 62. This is a really weird case, and not just because of the events of the story, but because it's unlikely that any site you look at is going to have the same story. Some things are added or taken away, but we did our best to include everything we could find out.
Though it is unknown how much of the story is truthful, since a lot of it is relying on the word of a mentally disturbed man.
Thank you for watching, we hope you found this interesting, and if you like us and want to support what we do, you can check out our Patreon, where you'll get early access to new videos.
We got